Hello, welcome back to part four. I apologize for this being a little long, but I want to make sure that I get the really, you know, important things in these videos right now, because they're very crucial. We're living in a day that time is very short, and I do want to get this message out to you from the Lord. Where I had left off, and when I was talking about the leaven of the Pharisees and of Herod, and the reason why that the Lord spoke those to me and what he was leading me to in regards to the Passover. If you see my little sign here, it says, let God change the way you think. And this is from Romans 12:2. And the message here is from Romans 12:2, is don't be like the people of this world, but let God change the way you think. If you give yourself to him and you give your life to him, then you tell the Lord, say, Lord, not my will, but your will be done. And we give up our will, and we turn our lives over to him. And in relation to the Passover, this is the time where they inspect the lambs. And so, and the lambs that were chosen during the time of the Passover, they were to be without blemish. And there was something else I wanted to share also. Hold on a second here. Now, during the time of Jesus, when we refer back to the Gospel of Mark, I spoke of the Pharisees, and also there was a group called the Sadducees, which was the same as the Pharisees, and they were looking for a sign from heaven. And they were tempting Jesus at that time. You know, remember that lesson. Well, they were very significant religious parties in the nation of Israel at that time. And what they believed about the scriptures is that they added from them, or they took away from what they thought was wrong with it. So basically that they added to the word of God their own traditions. And so what they did is that they made up thousands of man-made rules and placed them above the scriptures, and thus put themselves and others around them in a terrible spiritual bondage. And they still do that to this very day, what they call the Talmud. That was their own religious traditions. And what they believe is that their own religious observance of the traditions of the fathers, and they thought that they were pleasing God doing this. And the Sadducees were a party that didn't believe in the things supernatural, such as angels and spirits, and they did not believe in the resurrection of the dead, okay? And so basically what Jesus was warning about. The warning about the doctrines of the Pharisees, because they thought that they could do what they please, and they thought it would be okay with God. Well, that's the way things are going on today, and we can't do that. We have to be obedient to God and be His alone, and to be unspotted from the world. And that's what Romans 12 was referring to also. We have to renew our minds and not be part of this world. Don't be conformed to this world. Because the Lord does not want us, what is coming up on the earth, He does not want us to, be deceived. And the one about Herod is the same thing. Now, Herod was a political figure during the time of Jesus. And Jesus spoke of the straight gate and he was the straight gate. And he warned against Herod and his authority over Israel at that time. And Jesus went on his way through cities and villages and teaching and journeying on to Jerusalem. And one said to him, "Lord, are they a few that are saved?" And he said to them, "Strive to enter by the narrow door. For many, I say unto you, shall seek to enter in, and shall not be able. Even once the master of the house is risen up and has shut to the door, ye begin to stand without and to knock at that door, saying, Lord, open to us. And he shall answer and say to them, I know you're not whence you are. Then shall ye begin to say, We did eat and drink in your presence, and thou dost teach in our streets. And he shall say, I tell you, I know that not hence you are. Depart from me, all you workers of iniquity. And there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth when you shall see Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the prophets in the kingdom of God, and yourselves cast forth without. And they shall come from the east and from the west, from the north and the south, and shall sit down in the kingdom of God. And behold, there are last that who shall be first, and there are first that shall be last. And in that very hour there came certain Pharisees, saying to him, Get thee out and go hence, for Herod has find to kill thee. And he said unto them, Go and say to that fox, Behold, I cast out demons and perform cures today and tomorrow, and the third day I am perfected. And again, he was talking about his resurrection. Nevertheless, I must go on my way today and tomorrow and the day following, for it cannot be that a prophet perish out of Jerusalem. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, that killeth the prophets and stoneth them that are sent unto her. And how often would I have gathered thy children together, even as a hen gathereth her own brood under her wings, and ye would not. And behold, your house is left unto you desolate. And I say unto you, ye shall not see me until ye shall say, Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. From Exodus chapter 34, verse 25, And thou shalt not offer the blood of my sacrifice with leaven, neither shall the sacrifice of the feast of the Passover be left until morning. Now we turn to Exodus, the 12th chapter, where the Lord commanded Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, and he first instituted the Passover at that time, and that was the month, that was the beginning of the month, that shall be the first month of the year to them, the Israelites. And he spake ye unto all the congregation of Israel in the 10th day of this month. They shall take to them every man a lamb, according to the house of their fathers, a lamb for a house. And if the household be too little for the lamb, let him and his neighbor next unto his house take it according to the number of the souls. Every man according to his eating shall make your account for the lamb. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a male of the first year, and ye shall take it out from the sheep or from the goats, and ye shall keep it up until the 14th day of the same month, and the whole assembly of the congregation of Israel shall kill it in the evening, and that's in the twilight hours. And they shall take the blood and strike it on the two side posts and on the upper door post of the house wherein they shall eat it, and they shall eat the flesh in that night, roast with fire, and unleavened bread, and with the bitter herbs they shall eat it. Eat none of it raw, or sodden it at all with water, but roast it with fire, and his head with his legs, and with the in the inner parts thereof. And ye shall be nothing of it remains until morning, and that which remaineth of it until morning ye shall burn with fire. And thus shall ye eat it, with your loins girded, and your shoes on your feet, and your staff on your hands, and ye shall eat it in haste, for it is the Lord's Passover. For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night, and will smote all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast, against all the gods of Egypt. I will execute judgment. I am the Lord. And the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. And the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smote the land of Egypt. And this day shall be unto you for a memorial, and ye shall keep it a feast to the Lord throughout your generations, and ye shall keep it a feast by an ordinance forever. And 7 days shall ye eat unleavened bread, and even the first day ye shall put away leaven out of your houses. For whosoever eateth leavened bread for the first day until the seventh, that soul shall be cut off from Israel. And in the first day there shall be a holy convocation, and in the seventh day there shall be a holy convocation to you. No manner of work shall be done in them, and save that which that every man must eat, and that only may be done of you. And ye shall observe the feast of the unleavened bread, for in this self same day have I brought your armies out of the land of Egypt, and therefore shall ye observe this day in your generations by an ordinance forever. And in the first month, and the 14th day of the month, as even, ye shall eat unleavened bread until the 1 and 12th day of the month at even. And 7 days shall there be no leaven found in your house, for whosoever eateth that which is leavened, even that soul shall be cut off from the congregation of Israel, whether he be a stranger or born in the land, and he shall eat nothing leavened. In all the habitation shall ye eat unleavened bread. Okay, and when we go, we're going to go to the New Testament, because our Passover lamb and our unleavened bread and our first fruits are Jesus Christ, our Lord, who was given up as a sacrifice for our sins, because he is the unleavened bread, because he was without sin and without blemish, and he was our first fruits, because he was raised on the third day and resurrected to eternal life, so that we may have eternal life in him. He is God Almighty, our King, and our Sovereign Lord. Because according to 1 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, when we were gathered together on this day by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, may we be found worthy and to be called His own, and may we be saved in the day of our Lord. Purge out, therefore, the old leaven, and that ye may be a new lump, as ye are unleavened. For even Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the feast, not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice or wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. And may the Lord Jesus bless you, and come to Him today, and pray that you be counted in the ark. May God bless and keep you. Jesus loves you, and so do I. Y'all take care. Bye-bye.